Big Monday in Syracuse and Georgetown as our Big East matchup. Let's take a look at the starting lineup. Lucius Jackson and John Wallace up front. Otis Hill at the pivot. Adrian Autry and Lawrence Moten. Now in his third year, it seems like he's been around five seasons.
Right? Solid performer, and he's playing at home here. Excellent with the ball, the step-back jumper. This year, the pull-up jumper, draining him.
For the Hoyas of Georgetown, Reid, one of the most improved players in the conference, with Churchwell, Harrington, George Butler, their leading scorer, and Joey Brown, the man that runs the show.
And don't get too much red paint on his pants. Keep it outside. Find somebody. Don't over-penetrate, Joey. And not a bad-looking kiss by Joey Brown.
John Thompson, 22 years, the head man, and his record in this arena, a very impressive 85% with 156 wins. Jim Boeheim, 18th year, got to 350 wins faster than any coach in history, and got to 400 in less than 17 seasons. Right now he's at 426 and looking to make it 427 tonight. Critical game for Georgetown, 12-6 overall and 6-4 in the conference. When you look ahead, Raph, it's not too easy.
Well, why don't you say what you said at breakfast? You said it's going to be next to impossible.
Unless they put a string together.
They've got to win. So you're right. There's some tough pivotal games as you get down the end there. Connecticut, Syracuse, and all the in-between ones.
The reason I had so much time to talk about their schedule is you had a Ford bagel breakfast.
It wasn't paid. That's why. And a Boeheim said, wouldn't you be guest commentator for Georgetown?
I've had him twice in 3 days.
Huh? I said, I felt like saying to Jimmy, well, I like the other coach more. That would have destroyed his evening.
Well, he had one small smile before the starting lineups. We'll see if that continues. Reid and Wallace set to step in. Jody Sylvester, Ted Valentine, and John Cahill. Our officials were underway on Big Monday. And it's Othella Harrington to the hole.
You've got to protect the backcourt. Not a good beginning. But a juice.
Shows how Othella can do.
Jumper, and that's the vulnerable part. Look at this little high-low delivery, and John, who a lot of people would feel got a lot of ball, he's tagged for that one.
John Reid to the free throw line, averaging about 7.5 points.
Well, we have two guys who like to bang. John Reid and Otis Hill. They gather fouls.
Otis can foul out pretty quickly.
A few incomplete games. It sets up their pressure. Man-to-man, and they look to stay. They dribble into their lane, and they will double.
There's Hill outside.
Well, that's why you're going to step, I think, huh? It's a tougher match. 15.
Took one in the stomach, too, as he got the shot away. And he got it home anyway. Georgetown, their first turnover. Syracuse will run. Outside. Butler can't get it. And Syracuse ball with 18 minutes remaining first half and a 5-4 Syracuse lead.
You like the tempo. You've had a few walkers.
To speak. I think this all night.
They want to attack the press.
Strip, still Syracuse ball, they'll get a fourth opportunity.
Owen is a little bit frustrated, but attacking the glass, not a good sign for Georgetown. The one thing Syracuse says very well, they all handle, they are not afraid to take it to the goal versus the press.
Adrian Autry, player of the week in the conference, 47-point lead for 2 games.
And growing, running the show, coming up with big minutes and big plays. Still feel in his hand. He's letting the official know.
That one really hurt.
Everybody contributing a little according to the Syracuse coaches. Giving some help from the lines as well.
Nice fast start here. 7-6. Othella same spot. Had a motion again.
Reid down the box. Loves to bang that glass. They get the steps, huh? Why not take it? What's the extra bounce for?
And he points in his head as if to say, yeah.
Said, my bad.
My bad. Bad kids, enough that he sits.
My kids say that at home quite a bit.
Come on, you got good kids.
Oh, I do. I try that on my wife. Don't go too far.
Lillard checks in for him.
Churchwell showing his ability to the ball. That would have been an easy little jump ball situation. One thing about John Thompson's team, they have great confidence in attacking the glass. You can get some leak out for fast breaks because of that if you're real quick with the outlet, but they do give the little small change foul.
Othella's breather is over. Reid sits. Harrington back in.
Good players don't need that much time. An old Boston Celtic play.
Seen so many times when he rebounds on one end and gets that little bit of adrenaline flowing around. He gets down there and wants the ball on offense. That was a case there.
It's a different team when he does that. Nice protection there. And Joey Brown almost came up with it.
Wallace takes it all the way himself. Nice hook pass to Moten on the baseline. And the foul. The goal on Butler.
Brad, I don't know in your neighborhood if they made body contact. They probably just flicked it and ducked the head. But the kids today have an innate ability to draw a body, and that's what Lawrence did. He loves the contact, a little football in that young man.
This is a team that can shoot free throws, and that is different from last year. He's always struggled over the years. And now with the rest of the country shooting about 67%, here comes Syracuse shooting 72.5.
And Jimmy bragging about it, too. Think of these programs. Boeheim this weekend and Thompson will sit home and watch Derek Coleman and Patrick Ewing in the All-Star game. Tells you about the history, the story, rivalry of these two.
Patrick gave Mr. O'Neill a little bit of a lesson yesterday. He said he's an awful good young player, but he's not the man yet.
Well, as you know, Patrick has been out there.
Yeah, he was on with us almost a whole half there.
Stepping up his game.
Martin trying to give Syracuse a two-point lead and does with 50. 15 minutes, 13 seconds remaining first half. And Syracuse has taken a two-point lead.
As you see, Brad, that's with John Thompson. He was an old Celtic. And one of the things Red Auerbach did was that the big guy runs the floor. You're going to make sure that he gets the basketball in the three-second lane. This is a little delayed secondary break. But look at the pin down and Joey Brown responding to authority. Chance is keeping it there to Othello. He can do the rest.
Othello, 4 points so far. Want to get him the ball as often as possible. He has it.
Testing the outside shooting. Key for somebody to step up for the Hoyas.
The court goes checked in. So it's race night for Syracuse.
Moten has a size differential. He may be able to back him down. Or neutral and get something out of this.
Moten double on the baseline. That leaves a man open, but Wallace couldn't handle the pass.
Great help, and that's what Georgetown does beautifully. Rip Snyder caught behind, some the front. This is a deep post pass against the 2-3. That's a vulnerable area, and you've got protection. John's got good deployment on the baseline. You got to be concerned. And here, should have used the right hand, should have held off with the left. Part of growing as a post up.
We've seen some games where this kid doesn't touch it enough, and five times in nine possessions, this is that range you're giving it to him.
My coach when I touched it too often. But Clark mentioned that when he does get it, he's not a selfish player, which I think he should be more of. He'll give it to the other guys and they can step into a better shot.
Up to a 6 point start in the first 6 minutes.
Coaches have said he's getting himself free, much more involved, reading things beautifully.
Wallace had a career high against UConn, 25 points. And the Hoyas going back to their bench. And Churchwell, a baseline jump shooter.
And get steps on him, huh? On cue, unfortunately, for the Hoyas.
Back-to-back walks.
For that double up, right? Syracuse handled passively right now. They're looking pretty good. Guy has got himself
career high against Seton Hall. Average 4.6 of all game.
Over the years, you never know who's going to step in for Georgetown. When you put that scouting report, it might be Lamont Morgan one night, it might be John Kevin May. They can knock him down. It's the consistency that's the problem for John. Always searching.
John got the second. Right in the top.
A little more pressure.
Brad, they don't stop. That's what's incredible about them over the years. They need some fire out of their defense. Over the years, the fear of God when they put all the people down this end. And even here, look at the retreat and deflection. Good hustle.
Syracuse run, led by Lawrence Moten, who had five of those points in a hurry, Rap.
Well, poetry and Moten, as he is known up in Orange Country, lingered around the three, the knockdown. And this is one of the times now that Georgetown fails to cover. They're a great team at covering and helping. Miku got help a trip or two before that time. No assistance.
Butler still trying to get involved in the offense, and that'll go the other way. Charging foul. Foul is all he has to show for it. Moten off to a nice start. 9 points. 2 for 3 from three-point land. And that, for the time being, puts him ahead of Adrian Autry in second place in career threes for Syracuse. He's got that battle. Lawrence has 120. Adrian has 119.
And he can spot after a basketball.
Every time we go to Syracuse game, we end up saying, well, Moten's kind of quiet, or not this, not that. All of a sudden, look at him, he's got 24.
And you've always liked the high socks.
Yeah, I like the high socks.
See your wheels.
Covering,
but. Really got to play basketball at Lord Nichols. shoots me and it's five to four in the middle. Ristai's got a step in front, nice ball fake, and this does everything but go down. You mentioned, nice looking step.
He leads the team at his 24th of the season.
That shot, not my domain. Scotty trying to get everything, all the oomph in that body.
Concentrate, guys.
for Tuesday. Number 12, Indiana. Number 11, Michigan from Ann Arbor. Juwan Howard and company leading Michigan in that one. That is a key game in the Big Ten as they're tied for the top spot, both at 7-2. So a battle for supremacy in the Big Ten at stake. Nick Vitale now be there to bring you that one. Big Ten with a lot of teams with NCAA aspirations, but nobody can win on the road, it doesn't seem, except Indiana and Michigan.
I'm looking at Wisconsin and Minnesota. They've got to start getting it going on the road, as you noted. Important. Solid basketball teams. Stop. Get healthy, is it?
No, it isn't. What? Othella Harrington.
Box out. He's getting silent numbers now. I'd like to see some flashy, glitzy Las Vegas numbers.
Some rhinestones or something.
Some talent. Why would they hit on this? I think they can get after it, don't you?
They keep forcing the turnovers, and it's going to give them more and more opportunities. Right now, Othella Harrington has more than half of Georgetown's points, 8-15. That's what they're looking for.
Well, the guard's trying to help down in here. He can get it in time.
That's the ninth Hoya turnover.
I saw San Antonio play yesterday, and Sleepy Floyd was on the team.
Is that right?
Now, the first thing, well, how's the coach going? I said, no, we'll hit those backs. 78 third quarter. And the press, again, effective. He's now an assistant passer, and he beat Christian Center. But he went to the Hall of Fame here. And I remember some of John's early years, they had some quality coach, and they took you out of your game.
Joe Brown almost came up with a steal, and almost comes up with another one. Second to Sleepy Floyd, and career assists on Georgetown's record book. Jerry back in there with the wrist. A little more tape on that now.
Now watch this, though. You'd never go behind the back against him. Look at that. They're going to close on you. You're going to lose the ball. Nice high-low look.
And they're going to make Jackson pay for that bucket if he scored it. He didn't. But he did draw a foul. Second.
Let's go. Two.
And Harrington will sit as John comes back here. John Millen, Reid, John.
Brown had it, but didn't give it to Othello looking for that basketball. And so many shots. This is, I thought he was showing a little more enthusiasm. Initially, he didn't get it from the side. Churchwell made the move. But you've got to give him the ball. Now, he's looking at Joey Brown like, hey, Joey, get it down here.
So they walk it the other way. Basket good, but the foul will send Syracuse to the free throw line. He missed his first two, but he nails that one for Jim Boeheim.
You can really tell when he's successful.
Otis got them both, and the Orange men lead 26-17, just under four to go in the half. All-time Big East Conference victories. We've got the top two coaches right here, John Thompson and Jim Boeheim. And I'm looking through Louie and Rolly and PJ. Those are the two guys, charter members of the Big East, right?
Well, in fairness to them, they deleted.
Who was Seton Hall coach?
That was me in those days. Yeah, but there's right. The only two guys left, and these two are dinosaurs.
We had a second page of graphics where Rob's name showed up. We just didn't quite get to it.
Three pages, right? But these two are dinosaurs.
They sure are.
That'll be there shortly.
That's right.
So you fumble it, you're going to pay. Get it out of there. Quick decisions.
Georgetown in the 5-21. 10 turnovers and 34 possessions. Both point guards are struggling. One team with 3 points, Brown with two. An assist each.
Reid was great going to the goal. Here's the trap. The guy rotating back. JB with the kick and everything. But the completion here, Reid's able to hang on to protect himself.
A minute ago, I said that he should pick up the third one before halftime. He has. That'll do it for him for this half. Othella will sit. Don Reid, 6 points already at the free throw line. Georgetown as a team doing a pretty good job from the line, too. Not necessarily tonight, but 70.5% as a team.
Just relax a little.
Play within yourself. Fellas in and out. They try to pack it into it. up, you can't believe it's a four-point game.
A couple of super baskets, the easy ones, due to the steal. And going over the top, that's been an effective bucket against the press.
Seconds away from the Delta Fossa halftime report. John will be along. Daniel Marshall in deck. What a great player. Mark Kellogg's Robert Cross. And the new top 45 for us all come up at halftime.
Special K, well, he can play the game, and Daniel can as well.
Othella to the free throw line. A moment ago, I said it was a four-point game. They changed the scoreboard. I take it back. It's 26-21. 22 up there.
Great effort by Reid. And he just keeps on ticking.
History by Bruce. Blocked by Othella. His second goal.
Great position.
Straight possessions, or four of the last five possessions, turnover Syracuse.
Well, they got some life. Rich Snyder was fouled. That's how the ball ends up here, but that's gonna, you have to let it go as an official because there's so much action and contact when you're a pressurized team. A frenzy.
Left to work.
Grabber, look at Othella begging for the ball. He's being more authoritative, directing, begging, pleading, coercing. And you put Don Reid in there with him as he directs traffic. Reid attacking with reckless abandon. He takes somebody down if he doesn't get it.
Georgetown play for the final shot. The Hoyas of Georgetown 26-23 with you. Syracuse has not lost a game when they've led at halftime. 11-0 this year. They have also have not lost a game when they've out rebounded with a tie.
We're talking about the frenzy of Georgetown. A little press, the composure of Syracuse. It's important. Autry's the guy. He had got over the top line of passes that time. Step through. A lot of guys would have called the timeout. But Autry stepped through and had to kick down by Hill.
Wallace with the foul trouble. Has touched it eight times. And is now 3 points as he gets a free throw.
Down,
Brad. 4 minutes.
Yeah.
experience thing. A lot of guys would be rattled looking for the timeout. He sees the pass to Hill taken away, delivers deep, a strong send it in by John Wallace, and Reid, you check your teeth and your appendages, and he gives one.
Certainly, Lamar could come back on it. Now he'll head to the bench.
And hurts them now. They've established him on the block. He's kept things alive. And that replay point of view. Making things go loose.
He takes his spot to Georgetown.
The center down the lane, and he will hit them or dump to the corner. Now watch that arm and a discard. And underneath, the omnipresent and efficient. Number 5-0 switched to 5-5. I'm sure he's a little one on the jersey somewhere along the route.
Vaughn Morgan will come in. Joey Brown's going to sit back down. They'll have the free throw line. 13 on the night.
Back-to-back.
Career high 6 blocks in the win over St. Paul over the weekend. The Boston College game, one of his better games of the season, 22 points, 10 rebounds. And he's touched it almost half the time. Georgetown's had it. That's smart on their part.
Well, John has been looking for that. Are you ready?
solid second half free throw. Alabama coming in closer than three right now. 13 to play. Rebs lead over Georgetown. USA Arena. Landover, Maryland. Home of the Hoyas. Here's Alton Miller. Pass it 2-on-2. Four out.
Nice little play by the team. Landover switched Moten to the point where he hit the roll.
Release, Brad. What happens with Georgetown is they're in such a hurry to do something positive on the offensive end, they don't use the basketball knowledge that they possess.
Throw up that fly. Unfortunately, they have the numbers to catch the count. But just playing within yourself, very important. Hustle, but in control.
Hustle enough to force enough turnovers to only be down by one.
Snyder on the backside, and then when you trail a guy like this, it usually carries you strong to the goal and getting the ball the chance to reduce because of activity down the box.
Georgetown's going to just matched up. Holford's doing that it lasted seven shots.
And they did a little movie here on Saturday.
I heard you were part of that.
Well, and I'm just a cameo, and they're going to put my hands out in Hollywood. Georgetown won that one.
Georgetown down by one on this one.
To Othella Harrington because he's been able to get a lot of activity as he goes through the 3-second lane. He's going to get a bump as it reverses the ball. He says no. He's looking. He's going to be looking for the screen away. As he gets it, he's going to end up on the other side. Nice little dump down by Joey Brown. So well-defined, simplistic approach. Very effective.
And Othella has been effective. He's got 16 points and 12 rebounds. Pretty strong night. They need a lot more of him. They are down one. He's been good offensively.
Look at that mismatch, huh? Put him on a dribble. That's where he's king. Joey's having trouble.
Strong.
He just made this Snyder like Eddie and Carol, right? Willie Shoemaker.
Right.
And look at this mismatch. I mean, who would you pick in that little stale? Now he's going to go behind the back. Not what you'd call a good judgment by the big guy.
Right
there. Same little play. Here comes the screen for a nice little slide by Hill.
triple team.
Othello and Moten wisely knows he doesn't have any help on the outside, forces him to the middle and almost gets the support necessary. Pretty good screen by the capable ball handler, George Butler.
The leading scorer on this team, 13.8. You can see it's not been much tonight. And only field goal is this half.
And a nice little write up in the Washington Post tonight.
Yes! And for his fifth coach in fifth school over the last 5 years. Georgetown fan. Didn't take anything more than the offer. The coach out there sent Lamar and eventually is it either Spencer or Miller and a little shot. This is the first of our Bud Light triple header on Big Monday tonight here on ESPN, starting with the Big East that are moved to the Big Eight. Oklahoma and Oklahoma State follows this one at 9:30. And then at midnight, it's UNLV and Long Beach State. Three straight tonight on ESPN.
Regularity.
We were talking about that. He was going to He should. I think it's good enough that every night you expect him to get 20 and 10.
contested down there. Particularly with the quickness.
Last year, Othella had 18 points in the first matchup and 12 rebounds. 13 now in the second time. You see what he scored first with five. Tonight, 21 for the big fella. It's 10 out of 14 for the free throw line.
The wars go on, don't they?
Double-doubles and makes you come victorious. This one in the Boston College game, the strongest of those double-doubles.
Everybody vying for position right now.
Nice one in the win column for John Thompson as he gets close to 500 career wins, but he's still got 210 left to go.
Well, he's got a tough schedule ahead of him. He's got a lot of confidence. He's a team that can put some people away, do some damage. Very physical in the basketball game.
That's Lawrence Moten has not scored this year.
He's on 11. He's stuck on it. Working with some creativity out there. Doing a nice job on the set.
Thank you.
tickets he needed. And right here, the only good about this is stopping the clock. And then
you see him try to dribble right hand up when this is a normal left hand. Mm-hmm. He just really had trouble with it. In this case, last couple of free throws because of it.
Quickly that hand comes off. Yep, same as one for
Owen. He really pushes the free throw. And this Orange guy that's played this many minutes with an obvious injury that's hampered his play. He is the guy that plays the most minutes of anybody. He's going to try one hand in one here.
That's an amusement park.
On the back of the boards. Georgetown with a ball back.
And lucky he didn't get a 3-second call.
That's maybe the biggest rebound of the night for him.
Up though, I mean, Joey Brown is kid. I wouldn't bet against him. And right here, almost comes up with a deflection as he retreats, swipes. That's amazing. Good little dribble move by Sir Lawrence, who had been subdued in the second half.
Those times he'd like to get out and help the kid, help push the free throw.
See what he tries this time.
He's going to try to guide it a little bit more again. He has not hit a free throw tonight without ball risk.
Adrian Autry switches to the post in motion, and he gets it. incredible look that does not go down. The little bump affected, you know, the Shelly's leg by Reid. And right here, a rattler. On the Georgetown campus. That's not his normal number, and they can afford the letters for the uniform. There's a change of shirt. John really trying to slow it down and make him think because he's out of timeouts with the substitute.
Top, so they upset Syracuse tonight. They go to 13-6, 7-4.